everything just works. Everything just works.
Oh man, how great would it be to have RTX and DXR features on GTX cards?
Well, it looks like with a simple driver update, it is now possible.
We're gonna turn it on together. NVIDIA RTX, real-time ray tracing.
And so let's test the GTX performance with ray tracing and DXR features. I have some GTX cards, some RTX cards, my open bench is ready to go. Let's begin. All right, so what does it mean for existing GTX users now that you can enable ray tracing and experience those visuals and a nice hit on performance too, just like the rest of the RTX owners? But I feel like this approach has multi-layered consequence. So it's better for developers now that they can use GTX hardware instead of RTX hardware and experiment with ray tracing implementation and optimization. For gamers, you can now just experience the visuals, so see what it's like to have ray tracing in game, you know, BF5, Metro Exodus, and Shadow of the Tomb Raider, and potentially, will this nudge you to get RTX hardware? Probably not, but we'll see. And so I hope this will open up a stream of games that have some form of RT implementation, either shadows, reflections, ambient occlusion, or global illumination, or any other technique. And so ray tracing for the GTX cards starts at GTX 1060 6GB version, goes all the way up to the new Turing cards 1660 Ti. And so on my table today, I have a GTX 1060, GTX 1080, Titan XP, RTX 2060, and the RTX 2080 Ti to see how that entire stack of cards performs. So first of all, as Jensen said, it just works. Outside of updating your NVIDIA drivers and making sure you're on the latest Windows OS, the 1809, you don't have to tinker with anything in-game. You know, all the RT and DXR features should be visible to you with your GTX hardware. Now, as I've said in my previous analysis of BF5 and Metro Exodus, ray tracing has a massive potential to improve your overall immersion of the gameplay as long as the environment fits the whole ray tracing, you know, delivery. So as long as the environment is a major part of your observation and game, you know, ray tracing from my standpoint is approved. Now, BF5 is not that with its fast-paced shooter mechanic in which you don't really have time to stop and admire the reflections on wet surfaces or other reflective surfaces. But with this update, you can, with GTX graphics, see those reflections in action, but only from like a demo perspective, as the FPS hit is actually quite significant. So what you're watching now is running on the GTX 1080 for the win by EVGA, an 8700K at 4.8 GHz, and the game is running at 1080p resolution with medium quality settings. And since only the reflections are ray traced, the visual difference in like 95% of the gameplay is not noticeable, but at least we hit over 60 FPS with DXR enabled. I won't recommend it since it doesn't really benefit the overall gameplay experience, but Metro Exodus is another story. So with this game, I feel they've done a fantastic job with global illumination to improve the overall game world. And since this is a story-driven game, I would recommend replaying it with RT enabled if you can. Now the performance hit is massive, however. You can see over 100 FPS difference with my GTX 1080 at 1080p resolution with medium settings and high RT preset. So again, this game becomes almost like a demo of what's possible with ray tracing. Like the darkness gradient of the sewer entrance, you know, is very realistic versus it being totally illuminated by conventional means when the RT is off. Now, the reason why we're seeing such a significant hit on performance with GTX cards is because all the ray tracing is rendered on standard raster cores instead of the dedicated RT cores on the RTX graphics. Of course, that is inevitable. Now, in terms of SLI performance with ray tracing and GTX hardware, we were told that at first it's not possible and then that some games might implement it and it's kind of game dependent. So I would say SLI with ray tracing with GTX hardware is kind of a write-off. And so here's the performance breakdown with my five cards. The interesting thing is that my Titan XP Collector's Edition outperforms the RTX 2060, both in DXR on and off, which is quite interesting to see. But of course, all that changes when we move to Metro Exodus. So here we're using global illumination for our ray traced technique. And I think that is a lot more intensive. So not just reflections, but like all that light scattering around surfaces and interacting with objects. And looks like a lot more computational intensive for the RT cores or the Raster cores in this example. Moving on to the Atomic Heart demo at 1080p. So this one, it's a bit challenging. If you are willing to sit through about 10 FPS on average with a GTX 1060 just to see some, you know, beautiful graphics running at a really low frame rate, be my guest. And even with my 2080 Ti, it's still quite difficult to run. And the same story continues with Port Royal benchmark. This one's running at 1440p, so we're stepping up the resolution. But again, you know, I mean, those average frame rates on the GTX hardware is kind of laughable, but it's also very low on the RTX hardware, so it just shows how demanding this, you know, ray traced benchmark really is. And so the takeaway is that ray tracing works on GTX hardware now, no problems. I haven't experienced any crashes or any like visual differences between RTX hardware and GTX hardware. So that's a good thing. It's almost like it's enticing GTX owners to consider playing around with RT features and DXR in certain games and some demos to see what they're missing out on. But like we literally have only three games with, you know, these ray traced techniques applied to them. So it's not worth it just yet, but it does give you a little glimpse of like which direction we're heading in. And I'm hoping that we'll see more like good implementation of ray tracing in future titles, not just reflections, but like global illumination and shadows, so that it like builds this visual beauty into the game world that makes sense and is not just there for a tech demo.
Get a good sense of grip with Corsair's Ironclaw RGB gaming mouse, featuring a lightweight design, ultra-durable Omron switches paired with Pixart's 3391 optical sensor and some RGB lighting for some extra flair. The Ironclaw ensures gaming at its best. Check it out down below.
So make sure to update your drivers, play around with it, and let me know what you think of it in the comments below. I'm Dmitry, thanks so much for watching. If you haven't checked out my analysis of previous RTX implementations, make sure to do so. And I'll see you next video.